This is the Binding of Isaac, a really fast game focused on killing enemies and progressing in roguelike style. And this is my version of it. It features items recreated from the original game, procedural room generation, and much, much more. If you want to see how it works and the process of making it, stick to the end of the video. As you may know, the key to efficiency in projects is planning everything. I created a Trello board and added all pieces which I want to be in the game. Room generation, shooting, and some items and stuff. Yes, this is not everything which Isaac contains, but it was enough to satisfy me. Let's start with the first task, room generation. Room generation in Isaac is pretty hard to understand. By looking at the level generation page on Isaac's wiki, we can find pretty useful information about it, like how many rooms will be on the floor. But I had another plan. Instead of creating floors and other useless stuff which would probably bug out my code, I could create an endless runner, like you know, you just go ahead, and ahead, and ahead, and ahead, and ahead. First thing I created was the room designs. I made 8 different rooms, with 2 different styles, to add a little bit of uniqueness. Now let's start coding. Almost the entire code was pretty easy to do. Counting runs, making different seeds, except one thing, placing a room. I searched all around Google for around 3 hours to find an easy way to create it, but I couldn't find it. In the end, I decided to create it using structure blocks. You don't know what a structure block is? Well, I'm not shocked. This block is only available to get by /give command, and it allows the operator or mechanism to spawn a created preset. You have 4 options: save, load, corner, and data. We are interested in the first 3 of them. I made it, so every time you complete a room, a random corner structure block from the latest area is being taken, and then the number stored inside of it changes direction of how the next room should be placed. It had some technical difficulties along the way, but in the end, everything was solved. So, if we're done doing room generation, we need to make the most obvious mechanic of roguelikes, shooting. In the original game, we can attack using tiers. The amount of tiers per second can be calculated from this formula. Tiers equals to base tier rate multiplied by all modifiers. To recreate the mechanic, I had to choose between 3 different weapons in Minecraft: bows, snowballs, and decks. For the first shot, let's take a bow. As you may see, the loading speed of the bow is really slow, which is really not good to fire 5 shots per second. That's why I ditched it. It led us to 2 pretty similar items: snowballs and eggs. There are almost no differences between them, but as you may know, I'm lazy, so I didn't think a lot and chose snowballs. Okay, so now we can take a snowball and shoot it, but nothing happens. Why? Because we haven't made it yet. Do you remember the formula from earlier? Now we need to fill data into it. Let's take our default stats and put it into base tiers. Without any items, we don't have any modifiers, so we'll leave that as nothing. This is how many tiers we'll shoot per second, but there's a little problem. Minecraft uses a tick system to count time, which completely breaks our entire system. Instead of getting tiers per second, we need to get how many ticks pass between 2 shots. Each second contains 20 ticks. To get useful value, we need to divide the number of ticks, in Minecraft's case 20, by our tiers per second. Now, applying this to the code gets us working snowballs, but they still don't deal damage. Applying damage is pretty straightforward. We check if a snowball hits the target. If it does, deal your damage stat. That's it. Now we have our base. Actually, the game is already playable and we can have fun. But I want more, so I created this community post to get your item suggestions. And little to say, I got a lot of them. So I went to work and made a couple of them. However, there are 2 items that are worth pointing out: Brimstone and Jacob's Ladder. Brimstone in Isaac changes your shots to deadly lasers. However, there's a little catch. When you fire a laser, you can't change the direction. Recreating that wasn't easy. First, I had to create a laser, which seemed like a really hard task. But then, after a little bit of searching, I found this repository on GitHub, It helped me a lot because I only needed to type 4 lines of code to create a static laser, instead of like 200. It isn't dealing any damage or anything, but it works, so I guess it's fine. To make it work, we need to do maths. As you probably remember, yellow is the player, in this scenario me, and red line is brimstone. When I move, the brimstone isn't following me, so by doing more math and getting the difference between my laser and my position, I can move the end and start of a brimstone by the same amount of blocks. Now it works fine. Problem with no damage is really easy to solve. We need to create a bounding box, which is basically a rectangle and deal constant damage if someone is in it. Now brimstone works perfectly. What about Jacob's ladder? Well, in Isaac, it sometimes zaps enemies near your target. So I did it in Minecraft. When you hit a zombie, you have 50% chance to make it attack another zombie near it. This may lead to awesome electric bolts. Okay, now we have items, but how are we going to get them? This is the time for treasure rooms to shine. You get it? Because gold shines. Okay, I'm done. In the original game, treasure rooms are separate rooms that just contain an item inside. The item is taken from the treasure room pool and you can just go and stake it. So I made a room, but I was fooled by my genius. Couple years ago I posted a viral video on my old channel. It showed how to create an armor stand with hands. So that me thought I would making it the same way, which is creating armor stand, adding hands to it, giving item to its hands. And placing it in the best spot. But if you know something about Yandere Dev's style of coding, you'll know that it was a really bad piece of code. What could I do? Simply put it onto its head, as Mystica did in his video.
Armor stands spawned more armor stands below here with blocks on their heads.
After a little bit of polishing and additional coding and doing those stinky numbers to make it look at least good, it was done and the game is now playable in its full glory. If you enjoyed watching this video and you want to see more videos like this on your homepage, you can subscribe and like. I spent a lot of time on this entire project and I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see an actual gameplay from it, check Calvin's video in the corner. Bye! Mm-hmm.